Deputy Chairman, sir. I mean, Ashwadan Singh Dungopur from the Rajya Sabha chamber. Firstly, I would like to congratulate you on your second innings as Deputy Chairman, sir. Sir, India being one of the fastest growing nations in the field of civil aviation, and it's a booming sector. So this bill assumes all the more importance. So the amendments would fulfill the requirements of the International Civil Aviation Organization, ICAO, sir, which is a UN body, sir. So according to the latest reports dated 15th July 2020, India has been placed in category 1 of the ICAO report, and other nations like Pakistan and Malaysia are placed in category 2. So I don't know where my fellow honorable member have got those facts from. Sir, the audit conducted by ICAO in 2012 and 15 did indicate some needs to amend the act and give proper recognition to regulators to enhance maximum quantum of fines and empower the department officers to impose financial penalties and violations of legal provisions. So the penalties have been increased tenfold from 10 lakhs to 1 crore, sir. So in the year, also there has been a 2-year imprisonment, sir, in this. So the bill adds, this bill also adds air navigation services to the list for which the central government can make rules, sir. Sir, apart from DGCA, two other bodies to get statutory status will be the Central Aviation Security, BCAS, and AAIB. Sir, the government has needs to amend the new law after a spike of number of air safety violations, sir. So the most controversial being involving the Airbus A320neo planes fitted with Pratt & Whitney engines, which could lead to catastrophic consequences as such aircraft have faced mid-air glitches. So many a times one engine has failed, and once there was an incident where the second engine also encountered an engine glitch, and the aircraft had luckily landed safely back. But it triggered panic amongst the passengers, sir. So there was another incident on 29, 2018, where a Jet Airways aircraft, the crew forgot to put on the bleed switch, and there was air compression problems on the aircraft, and the aircraft had to return back to the base, and a number of passengers were hospitalized. So the Aircraft Amendment Act Bill 2020 also provides for keeping aircraft belonging to any armed forces of the Union and other naval from military or air force outside the purview of the Act, sir. So there are a number of important points I would like to make, sir, just a minute more. So one is the point of tabletop runways. As Mr. Reddy had pointed out, we need to expand the tabletop runways, and also we need to encourage private charter aircraft to promote tourism. So there are many airstrips lying all over the country unused, and even in small towns and villages. So I come from Dungopur, which has a population of 50,000, and we have an airstrip lying unused 11 kilometers away. So all such airstrips need to be utilized. Also, sir, we need to encourage seaplanes, and the initiative was first taken by our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji on Sabarmati when he first took off in a seaplane. So we can use the seaplanes in lakes, rivers, and we have a huge coastline. Also, private yachts need to be encouraged, so that will also encourage tourism, sir. And lastly, sir, the airports that handle maximum tourism, like Jaipur and Goa, needs to be upgraded a lot, sir. Also, in Rajasthan, the airports of Bikaner, Jodhpur, and Jaisalmer So they need to be upgraded and looked into. This is my request to the Honourable Minister, and with this, I support the amendments to the bill, sir.
धन्यवाद, धन्यवाद.